AGJA, the African Group for Justice and Accountability, has spent the past week here in this very beautiful city of Arusha. The judicial capital of the continent of Africa. Our first day was very, very productive. We held the biannual strategic meeting under the leadership of the Honorable Chief Justice Mohamed Othman. The members of the AGJA at the meeting adopted the Kilimanjaro principles, which give more flesh to our mission statement. What we committed ourselves as a group was to champion the cause of justice and accountability in Africa, to enhance complementarity by building capacity. We dedicated ourselves also under the Kilimanjaro principles to supporting the International Criminal Court and also promote universal ratification of the Rome Statute. We recognize also that as a group we have the possibility to facilitate, to mediate and promote dialogue between various parties within the ICC or even within the region in Africa in order to promote justice and accountability. Of course, we were meeting against the backdrop of two very important events which occurred on the continent. One was the announcement by Burundi that it intended to withdraw from the Rome Statute and that its parliament had approved the withdrawal and the president had in fact signed such a declaration. This was followed shortly thereafter by South Africa depositing an instrument of withdrawal from the Rome Statute. So in that context, we were, of course, quite concerned by these two developments. And as a result, the group issued two separate statements, one on Burundi and one on South Africa. And in respect of both of them, we did express our disappointment and concern. Condemnation, I think, is too strong. We would like to see ourselves playing a kind of mediating role as well.
I agree. Yeah. I think it's a deep regret and concern.
The strength of AGJA lies in its membership and its mission statement. It is comprised of African individuals who have tremendous experience and expertise in the field of international criminal justice. AGJA is an independent and an impartial, objective organization which has the ability to dialogue and mediate, to dialogue with African countries on this particular matter, to dialogue with the ICC, and to dialogue with all the states who have concerns on this particular matter. So its voice is one that can be heard and which can be effective.
I quite clearly state somewhere in there that Burundi has not withdrawn from the ICC.
President has to so approve.
Precisely, but so it's not a decision to withdraw.
It has overwhelmingly approved a bill that calls for the country to withdraw.
That calls for the country to withdraw. You can vote in Parliament in the legislature to support withdrawal or to call for withdrawal. But Parliaments can't, in and of themselves, withdraw a state from their own country.
Shouldn't we add a call to the President not to endorse it?
Yes.
Yeah.
We've reached out to organizations, to civil society, to member states generally, and also to the states, the two states concerned, in order to try and reach a common ground with them, which will see the continued membership of these states within the Rome Statute, and a resolution of whatever concerns they may have within the system of the Rome Statute itself.